mess up here and everything. Okay, gotta pull up on this phone, everything. Yeah, instead of buying, like, a laptop or a tablet, because a tablet would be cheaper than a laptop, just buy a second phone, and the cover and everything included would mean then it's equivalent to $100, and then you just have one for entertainment, and it works. You just switch phones when one dies. And you can add, when one fails, you can add, change services, or add service to one of the phones. Okay. Sorry, it's not at all what the video is back. I got distracted. I had to pull up my phone because I'm not going to say this name correctly. It's Matt Rife. I'm pretty sure it's Rife. I want to say Rifle. And I was like, that's not your name. Matt Rife. Anyway. So, it's midnight right now, and I need to pull up the name real fast because I was watching a YouTuber that I follow just posted a video. It's not Jonah Finch, it's James. What is your name? Jamie Duck? Jamie Dodger. That's the name anyway, underneath their channel and everything. They are talking about, they are saying their video is called Did Matt Rifle End His Career? And I just wanted my 2 cents on it and everything like that. Because I'm pretty sure I've seen it, and I've seen quite a few clips of him, and I think it's pretty funny, and I don't think it's offensive. And I disagree with what he was saying. He was like, they're offending people and everything. And insulting different minority groups and disabled people and trans people and LGBT people. And they're just saying things that they shouldn't be saying. But I do agree with their sentiment in the first place, that he shouldn't have said his first opening line, his first joke about, his joke, he opened a joke about abuse and everything, and I do agree with them, about Jamin on that topic, that, hey, you shouldn't have said that, because it's insensitive, because it's putting, okay, I guess backtrack a little bit. So what he's saying is that, you wouldn't end up with a black eye if you cooked, and, or if you were just in the kitchen, and that's all BS, and that's putting blame on the victim. You're accusing the victim of being like, oh, if you just were nicer, if, oh, you helped out, or if, oh, you did your job, what you're supposed to, your role as a woman, and all that crap, then no one would hate you, and then it's excused in that he was okay and he was right to hate you. They're like, oh, if you didn't do that, he wouldn't hate you. No, he would have probably hit you regardless, and that's wrong. It's an abusive relationship, and you should get out of it. And people still struggle with that and still blame themselves when it's not their fault for things in that situation. And we haven't quite moved on enough and developed enough as a society where it's not really a problem anymore. It's still a problem that a lot of people have to deal with, and it's an actual problem that we still apparently can't move past. So we're not able to make jokes like that, or really joke about it in general. I don't think we're quite able to joke about it yet. And that joke itself is victim blaming, so maybe we could word differently. And maybe if we were more developed and it wasn't such a big issue and such a current problem and a reoccurring problem, and it was something that people didn't blame themselves for, then maybe we could joke about it, but we're not at that point in society, and we're not able to do that. Okay, so with that, I do agree with Jamie Dodger that, yeah, he shouldn't have said that, and shouldn't be blaming the victim or victim blaming the person who's being abused in a relationship. Okay. So not a great start. But the next point he's trying to make and he's talking about is, I've seen this joke quite a few times, and I was not offended by it whatsoever, and I think it's perfectly fine. Yeah, I'm trans, whatever. Don't care. Yeah, but his whole joke is I don't think it's offensive whatsoever. He'll overreacting about it, and his whole point is, like, you can't make jokes about them, but you can, and people shouldn't be offended by his joke in this matter. I think it's wrong in this matter. I think Jamie Dodger is wrong to be offended and doesn't understand that it's a joke, and it's mostly a joke because it's true and it's a fact and it makes sense. And it's not putting anyone down or saying or really comparing two problems. Okay. I need to explain what he said before I continue what I'm saying. So, the quote of Matt Rife and everything, he's talking about how he says that, he goes on, before this to explain, hey, you can't make, you're not supposed to make fun of trans people, you can't make fun of trans people. And then he goes into his joke, which is, it's not like, I'm not using the correct words that he used. But if you compare trans difficulties and stuff like that to his problems, obviously they do not compare. He does make that clear that, yeah, he's, and you know from context and everything, that he's not trans, he's a cis white man who is making money off of making jokes and stuff like that and just being popular online. So, yeah, he's more privileged. And he doesn't suffer from these problems or these issues. So he doesn't know what it's like to be trans. Okay, sorry. Makes that point clear, and that's all fine. But, I'm not gonna say this quite correctly. But yeah. But he says that, you can't really compare words. Okay. A trans person's life and a non-binary's life and LGBT member's life isn't as hard as someone who has a disability in most cases, and especially if you compare it to someone with a disability in a wheelchair. He obviously didn't use as many words as I'm using and explaining this as a depth. Of course, he didn't do that. But he's like, oh, if you compare a trans person's life to someone in a wheelchair, yeah, their life is not as hard as someone who's in a wheelchair or who has someone who has a disability. Which is true, and it makes sense, and it's valid. It's a simple fact. And then he goes on to joke about how, how society and everyone just gave people with wheelchairs and with disabilities like a couple ramps or a few things to try and help, but that's it. They gave them a few ramps, and that was it. And said they were happy about it. Which is wrong. We do need to make better resources and make sure we have resources for people who have disabilities and make sure that they have the help that they need and that they have the tools that they need and the medications that they need and that the financial help that they need and different services to help them. Yeah, this turn. But that's a different matter and that's not what he was talking about. And he didn't insult anyone. And that's my point. He didn't insult anyone and he didn't hurt anyone. And yeah, if you compare someone who's transgender or is trying to figure out their sexuality or their gender identity, that's definitely not as hard as suffering, having a disability or living your life in a wheelchair. Yeah, there are different issues, different problems. Yeah, your life isn't as hard, and it can be solved quite easily. You just need, what's for a transgender gender identity person, you just need to do a lot of self-validating and just figure it out for yourself, and then once you're confident in that, you can seek help, and you can seek validation, and find someone who loves and supports you. And you can get validation from other people, and obviously love yourself and get some love from other people who love and accept you, and you can move on with your life, and you can get medical therapy, you can get some medication, you can get hormone therapy if you need to, if you want to, or if you look into it. Obviously, not everyone can, because they're like, I need money, but that's everybody's problem. Everybody needs money. We all need money. I got off track. I was like, everyone needs money. We're all poor. We're all broke. We're all dead. Unless you're obviously rich, then you're rich and you have your own problems. Shoot, go away. We don't need you here. Not involved in my problem. Yeah. And then obviously surgery costs even more, so you just need money. Yeah. So that was my point and my take on it. That Matt Riff, as a comedian, isn't offending anyone or hurting anyone with his joke in this context. And I've seen a few more sketches at least than Jamie Dodger, and I didn't see anything that was offensive or that was hurting anyone. And in this situation, I think he was definitely wrong. You have your opinion, you have your belief, but I don't think it's the problem here. And I think the online people who are talking about, oh, you can't compare, well, you can't compare and you don't understand the struggles of trans people. Yeah, he doesn't know, and he's not comparing his life to them, or saying that it's invalid and that they don't struggle. He's not saying that they don't have problems, and that it's not a real problem, and it's not a real identity, it's not a real issue. He's just saying, if you compare that problem, if you compare dysphoria, gender dysphoria, and dysphoria to not being able to walk, obviously not able to walk is higher and it's more of a problem. It makes sense. It can be, and he says it in a funny manner and funny context, so yeah, it's funny. I laugh at it. Whatever. No one needs to be offended by it. He's not making that, oh, he's not saying you don't struggle or that you don't have problems. Everybody's got problems. Oh yeah, you have more problems and a different kind of problem. But it's not the same. It's not on the same level. If there's a scale, yeah, it's a higher problem than someone who's cis. But it's a lower problem with someone who has a disability. I don't feel like I should or need to explain this, but apparently I do. Because they made a stupid video. So took way longer than I wanted it to. Hopefully I was as clear and concise as I wanted to be. Hopefully it made sense to you. I'm saying that Matt Rife is not wrong. I had to repeat it multiple times because I don't believe or trust in myself that communication is happening. But yeah, that's my whole point, is that he's not insulting or offending anyone and it's not a big issue. And on a separate note, I think that society and that the government should probably do a little bit more, help people a little bit more than that they do with disabilities. Because they still have issues, and not everyone's is always covered, and they're not always, they can't always get the services and the help that they need. And that's a problem. And it's not a problem people like to talk about, or that have been really brought up. It's more of a problem that was really brought up in the past, but then they were like, oh, we did a little bit, so go away. We helped you a little bit, so we solved all your problems. No, not all of your things fixed, not all the problems are fixed. Problems are still there, and there's still stuff that can be done. I can't do anything. Maybe other people can. And something should be done, and people should help. Yeah. Obviously, it has improved, but there's always more. There's more, always more that people in power can do. I don't really have hope, because not that the government listens to people, or that the people really affect the government, and that you can vote for whoever you want, but the person you vote for can vote for whoever the hell they want, and say and believe whatever the hell they want, and there aren't any consequences, and there's no one they have to listen to, there's no one they have to report to. Yeah, I'm on a different topic, sorry about that. Went off a little bit more of a different rant. I made a point earlier, sorry about ranting about other stuff, that's everything. Bye, whatever, goodbye. Ah, gotta hit the stupid button.